Starts right now.
Troubling and inaccurate. Southern Maine school officials say Governor LePage is blaming them for something that's simply not true. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. Last week, a bill created by Governor LePage that would give uniformed military recruiters unlimited access to secondary schools failed in the House. This after a recruiter told the Department of Education 7 Southern Maine schools were giving them minimal access. WMTW News 8's Aly Myles has been following the story, and she's joining us now live with the latest. Aly?
Tracy, a spokesperson for the military recruiter who initially made these claims, says he did so in a response to a question from the Department of Education.
Minimal access and ineffective visits. Command Sergeant Major Richard Hannibal wrote the letter to the Department of Education back in May. His spokesman says these aren't, quote, huge problems, but the military hopes to have them addressed. The governor did just that, handwriting 45 letters to legislators who voted against his bill, and in his weekly address said the failed bill was, quote, one of the most appalling moves of the session.
One Democrat even said he's more inclined to believe our local superintendent than a military recruiter. I'd bet my life on the word of a recruiter over a superintendent any day of the week and twice on Sunday.
The 7 schools the statement says are only allowing minimal access are Kennebunk, Noble, Oak Hill, Wells, York, Gorham, and Yarmouth. The statement and the governor also said Portland and Yarmouth have denied uniformed recruiters from stepping on campus. Yarmouth school board chairman says that is a lie.
What's troubling to us in Yarmouth is that our school was singled out and singled out wrongfully. So I'd like everybody to know that what the governor said about the Yarmouth schools is not accurate.
Ray and Kennebunk Superintendent Andrew Doloff says they're willing to reach out to the governor or recruiters to figure out how these claims started in the first place.
We'd invite the governor or his spokesperson to come on down and see how we handle military recruiters in our schools, and they would see that they just got it wrong.
What we're going to do is reach out to the recruiters actually tomorrow and see if we can set up a meeting and make sure that we're addressing their concerns.
Now, it's already a federal mandate to allow recruiters unlimited access to secondary schools, but LePage also says in his weekly address that he encourages Mainers to find out where their politicians stand on this issue because, quote, this will not be the last time this bill is introduced. Live in the studio, Aly Myles, WMTW News 8.